Hello everyone, welcome to this tutorial, and in this video tutorial I will discuss about performing different normality tests. And normality test is a very important concept, especially for the mean comparison, and if data is normal, then we normally follow parametric test opposed to the non-parametric test for not normally distributed data. So for example, if we want to see whether data is normally distributed or not, so if it is normally distributed, then in mean comparison test we can perform t-test or ANOVA. But the opposite is the equivalent could be Mann-Whitney test or Kruskal-Wallis test when we have not normal distribution of the data. So how can we identify the distribution of the data is whether it is normal or not normal? Now in this video tutorial I will discuss three ways we can use to identify that. So the first technique is about the some pictorial view we can call. From a statistical point of view, this is histogram. So we have a sample data about the variable size, and we have different value for this variable. Now, if I want to see whether data is normally distributed, then we can test that through the histogram. So under the command option in the subtree STATA, you type his. So histogram, so there's the concise form here, hist, H-I-S-T. And then you need to put your variable for which you're actually testing the normality. In my case, it is size. So hist size and then comma and then type frequency and then normal. So hist then variable name comma frequency and normal, and if I press enter you see this graph is showing the distribution of data through the histogram. And normally if your data is normally distributed, then you will find it is actually bell-shaped, but here it is actually rightly skewed. That means in right hand side you see it is skewed. That means data is not normally distributed. This is the first way. The second way is through the test statistic. You can identify whether your data is normally distributed or not. So here are two methods we can apply here. One is Shapiro-Wilk test, another is Kolmogorov-Smirnov test. So for the Shapiro-Wilk or Kolmogorov-Smirnov test, your null hypothesis is that data is normal, and your alternative hypothesis is data is not normal. In other words, if you find your p-value is not significant, that means if it is above 5%, that means your data is normal. However, if your p-value gives you a significant value, so if it is less than 5%, then it indicates that data is not normal. So in other words, we can say that for the null hypothesis, here would be that distribution of data is not significantly different from normal distribution. That means data is normal. So this is normally opposite of our traditional concept that when it is alternative hypothesis, this actually indicates a good result. But here we're actually looking that our results should be insignificant. If the result or your test statistic is insignificant, that actually good for you. That actually means that data is normal. So to perform the Shapiro-Wilk test, so under the command option, you type swilk, S-W-I-L-K, and your variable name, that is size, and press enter. Now, if you looked at the test statistic value here, the probability, the p-value of this result, you can see this is 0.00000. So this is highly significant. That means you should reject the null hypothesis. In other words, you are actually rejecting your null hypothesis, which indicates that data is normal. So this significant value indicates, p-value indicates actually your data is not normal. The second way of testing the normality is through the Kolmogorov-Smirnov test. And for the Kolmogorov-Smirnov test, your command should be, if I type here, so KS Mirnov, and then your variable name, like size here, and that should be equal to the normal, and first bracket, and again first bracket, your variable name, size, and from there you need to deduct the mean value of the variable you're using here, so that is mean value of the size, and close the bracket, and that should be divided by the standard deviation of your variable, that is size, and close the bracket. So we need to use this command. So far we have seen this command, but the problem here is that I need to get information about the mean value and the standard deviation of the variable size. So before running this command, first we need to get information about these two issues or two things, like mean and standard deviation. So how can we do this? Very simple. So if I type under the command option sum and your variable name, that is size, press enter, and this will simply show you what is the mean value and standard deviation. So if I then use this command to get the Kolmogorov-Smirnov result, so KS-MIRNOV, so this one, and then your desired variable name for which you're actually performing this normality test, that is actually size, and then equal, then you need to type normal, first bracket, and then size, that is your variable name, minus mean value of that variable. So we know the mean value of this variable is 12.2029. So if I put it here instead of that, so this is actually showing the mean value of that variable, and that should be divided by the standard deviation of that variable. So my standard deviation here is 7.295405. So if I copy it here and paste it here, so KS-Smirnov, your variable name is equal to normal, first bracket, your variable name minus mean value, and bracket close, first bracket close, and then divided by your standard deviation of that variable, and then again bracket close. And if you press enter, and you will see the result here, and you can see here that the p-value here, especially the combined case, this is statistically significant. So this means you have to accept the alternative hypothesis, or you need to reject your null hypothesis. So that means your data is this results indicates that your data is not normal, because this is significant. So in this way, we can perform the normality test and check whether your data is normally distributed or not in the subtotest data. Thank you.